Hello. In this video, we're going to derive expressions for the gain input resistance and output resistance for the common drain amplifier, which is also referred to as the source follower. And so I have drawn the basic structure of a common drain amplifier. This will be an NMOS transistor, M1. And I have also drawn the small signal equivalent circuit. You can see how I have replaced the transistor M1 with its module. And so this will be Vin, Vout will be out here. And now I want to find an expression for the voltage gain. And so I can basically find expressions for Vin and Vout, and then find the ratio of Vout over Vin. So my Vin, I can see that it is VGS plus the voltage drop across the RS resistor, which in turn is GM VGS times RS in parallel with Rout. That may not be very obvious, but to see that RS is in parallel with Rout, but notice that they're both connected between the output node and ground. So I can write this as VGS plus Vout, basically. Or VGS plus GM. VGS RS in parallel with Rout. And I can factor out VGS so Vin will be equal to VGS times 1 plus GM RS in parallel with beta level. And my Vout, the voltage here, is again going to be basically Vn VGS times RS in parallel with Rout. So Vn VGS times RS in parallel with Rout. And again, this may not be necessarily obvious for you to see, but you can easily see how you can redraw the circuit in the following fashion. VGS, this is my source, this is RS, right? And now notice that this is my output terminal, Vout. And I have R literal connected between Vout and ground, so I can put it here. And my current source, VGS, also connected between Vout and ground, with the current flowing away from the ground node and into Vout. So something that looks like this. So this may make it easier for you to visualize those equations. Now the expression for my voltage gain will just be Vout over Vin, or essentially Vm VGS times RS in parallel with little row divided by VGS times 1 plus Vm RS in parallel with Rout. We can cancel out the VGSs. And be left with Vn equal to Vm RS in parallel with little row divided by 1 plus Vm RS in parallel with little row. In some cases, we may neglect the effect of little rho and just approximate this as VmRs over 1 plus VmRs, based on the fact that typically little rho is going to be much larger than Rs, and therefore Rs is going to dominate that parallel combination. In any case, typically, we will have that GmRs is much greater than 1, and therefore the voltage gain of the source follower can be approximated as 1, and that's the name source follower. Now, to calculate the input resistance should be easy enough because it's the resistance looking at that input terminal, which is in essence an open circuit, and therefore we say the input resistance is equal to infinity, and the output resistance, that's going to be a little bit more complex, but nonetheless it's easier to visualize if I apply my other model, my T model for the transistor. So basically I have my current source Gm times VGS connected to ground on the top. I'm going to ignore little arrow this is going to be 1 over Gm to my source, then I'm going to have my RS resistor. My output is taken at the source, which will be here. That's V out. This is my gate, so this will be V in. Then, in essence, this will be my VGS voltage. So that's my gate. That's my source. This is my drain. And I can see my R out resistance looking into the output terminal. It's going to be approximately equal to RS in parallel with 1 over Gm. Then when I'm calculating my output resistance, notice that I am turning off my signal sources. And typically 1 over Gm is going to be much smaller than RS, and therefore I can approximate this as 1 over Gm. So this will be my input and output resistance for my common drain amplifier. Typical uses for this type of amplifier is going to be as a buffer between stages, for example. And that's because it has a very high input resistance, a very low output resistance. The gain is essentially 1. And so as a buffering stage between amplifiers to avoid loading effects, or, you know, even as an output stage to avoid loading by the output, there's an input stage because it has the high input impedance and will avoid loading. It will avoid loading at the input. So let's make perhaps a little note. Typical application is as a buffer to avoid loading effects due to good I out characteristics. Thank you.